Humans are social animals, and humor is the most important thing that we have. We use it to make friends, we use it while dating, we use it to show off our charisma. But why? Why do we need humor to make friends? Why do we need it while dating? What is humor exactly, and how can I be funny? Those are the questions that I'm going to answer today. Welcome to Brains Applied. Humor is so important because it shows that you have confidence, and it shows that you are comfortable in a given situation. And when you crack a joke, you make other people also feel comfortable in that situation. And more importantly, when you crack a joke, laughing is a positive experience, and people will remember this positive experience. People will start to relate this positive experience to you, and that is why humor is so important when making friends. Additionally, some researchers have claimed that humor is even more important than having good looks when you're dating. And we can explain this by the sexual selection theory of Charles Darwin. Darwin distinguished between intrasexual selection and intersexual selection. Intrasexual selection means showing physical dominance over other people, showing that you are stronger and fighting them. And this is what many animals do during the mating season. They fight with other males to gain the approval of a certain woman. This is also the reason why some bullies and gangsters are so attractive. It's intrasexual selection. They show their physical dominance. Intersexual selection, on the other hand, means showing that you have better traits than other people, showing that you have the best traits. And these traits can be a lot of things. They can be confidence, they can be empathy, and they can be humor. And you might be wondering, why is humor so important for mating? What does cracking a joke have to do with mating? When you have a lot of humor, you show that you have a lot of social skills. You show that you have a lot of intelligence. You show that you are an intelligent person. And this is very important. It shows that you have a lot of a woman's favorite male organ, the brain. It shows that you have good genes. And with genes, I mean DNA, not the denim. Flirting is strongly related to humor. And the cool thing is that women are specifically looking for men that can make them laugh. Because they have good DNA, they have good genes, they are perceived as more intelligent. Men, on the other hand, are looking for women that actually laugh with their jokes. Because making jokes and laughing with jokes are a sign of some sexual interest. And this is, of course, very important to men. The next question is, why is something funny? What makes humor? There are a lot of different theories about why something is funny, but the most appreciated, most well-known theory is the benign violation theory. The benign violation theory states that something that is funny is a violation, but it's some kind of good violation. It's a benign violation. From an evolutionary perspective, such a violation is a physical threat, a threat to your safety. But over time, this also became a threat to personal dignity, a threat of social norms and of moral norms. And such a violation can be benign in many different ways. For example, it can violate one norm, but it can be good according to another norm. Another way in which a violation can be benign is when someone is not that committed to the norm. When someone realizes that there is a violation, but they're not really threatened by it. They don't really care. The last way in which a violation can be benign is psychological distance. This can be temporal distance. For example, a lot of comedians make jokes about the Holocaust, but also spatial distance, social distance, and hypothetical distance. The last question that you're probably asking is, but how can I be funny? Let me give you some tips and techniques that are often used by comedians. Remember stories that happen during your daily life. Stories show that your life can be fun and that you can make fun out of your life. Jokes are just a few funny sentences that you remember. is the same as using a cheesy pickup line on Tinder. They don't show anything. They show that you can remember one sentence, and they show that you are interested in the girl, but the cheesy pickup line doesn't show that you are funny as a person. Comedians don't remember jokes, they remember stories. Here's an example of Trevor Noah.
I remember the worst encounter I had with the TSA was out in Burbank, California. Tiny little airport, and I was flying out and I was coming to New York, right?
Another often used technique is the rule of three. Comedians put a certain pattern in their story that occurs three times. The first two times the pattern creates some tension. It builds up surprise. The third time something funny happens and this makes people laugh.
And so I'm in Burbank Airport and I go through security and then for some reason I was beeping. I don't know why. I walk through the metal detector and I beep. Go out, beep, go out, beep, go out. And every time I have to take something off, I go out a beep. And the agent, he's just losing it. The whole time he's like, take that off, take it off. And I'm going like beep, beep, beep. He's like, take that off, take it off. And I come back, he's like, take that off. He's getting more and more angry. I'm basically naked right now and he's losing it. Like I felt like an underperforming stripper. It was horrible.
The next technique is acting out your story or your jokes. Use the accents that people use. Try to imitate their gestures. Imitate people. It makes your story much funnier and much more lively.
He's just like, take no, just ah! And finally, he's like, you know what? Just get out here. Get out here. Get out here. So I walk to the side. He's like, go ahead and put your hands up. Go ahead and put your hands up. Put my arms up. And he whipped out a little personal metal detector. Yeah, it looks like a midget sword, right? But they call it the wand. That's what they call it, the wand. And so he whips that out. Yeah, because that $100,000 machine. That's play. Shit just got real. So he looks at me and says, go ahead and stick your hands up, sir, and just keep them right there. So I put my arms up and he scans me. He's like,
as a last tip, give people some time to laugh. Plenty of people keep talking in their jokes and stories to fill up awkward silences. But comedians don't do this. They use silence in their advantage. They take a second to breathe. And this allows people to process the joke and laugh.
You got any metal objects on you? And they went, well, then what was that for? If you were gonna ask me anyway, then what was this? The foreplay to my honesty? What is this? Why?
Hey guys, as you can see, it's already dark, or not really, because I still have the lamps, but I unfortunately forgot to film the ending of this video, the part where I say subscribe. So here we go. If you like this video, press the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you receive a notification next time when I upload a new video. I really do hope you liked it, and I will see you guys later.